Hello everyone, and welcome back to What's What. In today's episode, we are going to talk a bit more about electric charges, how they flow, and what objects best conduct them. But before we start shaking up this episode like lightning in a bottle, don't forget to like and subscribe below. In electrical engineering, a stream of charged particles is called an electric current. A conductor is a type of material that permits these charges to flow. The opposite of a conductor, or something that stops electric current, is an insulator. Oh no, but don't worry, our electrical journey isn't over just yet. Generally, metals are the best conductors of electricity. But liquid can conduct electricity as well, such as water, for example. And especially if that water contains impurities. Salt water is a great natural conductor of electricity. But did you know the human body is a conductor as well? Our bodies are made up of a significant amount of water and therefore are conductors. But other factors can alter our level of conductivity, such as stress or skin moisture. But don't worry, friends, electricity won't hunt you down. And if it does, there are cool ways to stop it. So, we know that conductors permit the flow of electricity, but what are insulators and how do they work? Like mentioned before, insulators prevent electric current from flowing freely. Their main property is resistivity, and like conductivity, it can be measured. Now, obviously, insulators have higher electrical resistance than conductors, and they mostly come in the form of non-metals like rubber or plastic. But no insulator is perfect, because every material has some sort of electric charge within it. And insulators can become conductive when a large enough voltage tilts through the electric field. Lucky for us, that is highly unlikely. Some other examples of insulators are glass, dry wood, styrofoam, and even air. Take your overhead transmission lines, for example. The cables themselves are bare conductors, and we can never touch them. But what separates us from their electric field is actually the air itself and those beams from which they hang. Without them, things could get a little shocking. Insulators are often used hand-in-hand with conductors, typically to support and separate currents, cable lines, and other electrical equipment. And so, without blocking the electricity flow required for that equipment's function. Again, metal takes the number one spot when it comes to conductors of electricity. But which metal, you ask? That's when things get kind of tricky. Funny enough, it is actually silver that takes the gold medal, copper that takes the silver medal, and gold that takes the bronze medal, in regards to the best of the best of conductivity. So there are our top three, but in a close fourth place is aluminum. Copper and aluminum are most commonly used in the industry, and that's especially the case for power grids. This is because of their affordable cost compared to others, even though they are subject to cost variability on the metal market. Gold, on the other hand, is more typically used in computing and electronics as a thin film to coat and protect silver and copper from corrosion on printed circuits. But the most elite conductors are none other than the superconductors, as you may have heard in a previous episode. If you don't remember, these are the conductors with a level of zero resistance. In electronics, semiconductors are used more frequently. The reason for that, they are particularly insulating, but can easily be transformed or manipulated. Electrical conductivity is the result of movement of the electrically charged particles. Silver, copper, and gold have one electron in the outer valence shell of their atoms. This makes it easier for them to create current. And for a current to form, a charged particle simply needs to nudge into another charged particle. And then that charged particle will nudge into another. And that charged particle will nudge into another. And then, and then another, and then another, and then another. Okay, you get the drift. Resistance, conductivity, electrons. How do we measure all this stuff? First, electrical resistance, represented by R, measures the object's opposition to electricity flow. Electrical conductivity, measured by G, is its reciprocal quality, measuring the ease in which a current can travel through it. Typically, if you want to find an object's level of resistance, R equals 1 divided by G. When conductive materials transmit a current, the Joule effect leads to the dissipation of energy via heating, and this is proportional to the resistance and to the square of the current intensity. My job, yes, I have another job, believe it or not. Well, it mostly deals with calculations and cable design in regards to overheating prevention, degrading or melting of insulation, especially in high voltage networks where huge amounts of power are transmitted. Thank you very much. But whether it is a small wire used to power a device in your home or a large piece of copper used in the grid, remember that. A conductor is an object that transmits electrical current. An insulator is an object that stops current flow. The best conductors are usually metals, silver, copper, and gold. The human body is also a conductor. Some examples of insulators are rubber, plastic, glass, and air. Insulators are used to protect or control conductors. And that's all we have for today. Got any thoughts or questions about conductivity? Feel free to leave a comment below. And remember to always keep charging those cells in your brain and let the science flow.